As you know, there are about 35 different interpretations of quantum mechanics. You can check that out on Google, or Wikipedia was referred to as the Copenhagen interpretation, where an observer is required to collapse the wave function. The wave function is a cloud of probabilities in a field of infinite possibilities, and predicts the outcome of collapse of the wave function as the appearance of a particle in space-time. And it's a mathematical recipe for predicting outcomes. And it's very accurate and is the basis of modern technology. However, there's a huge argument what it means. The Copenhagen interpretation implied the role of consciousness, and that has kind of become unfashionable these days. Dominant theories today are multiverse, and which imply infinite universes, and then there are other theories, cubism, and many others. But here's a theory that I feel could have validity. And so, I asked a number of physicists whether it is possible that the collapse of the wave function is related to the quantum field appearing as both the observer and the observed through its own self-interaction. And so I found out, much to my pleasant surprise, that this is being explored by some physicists, even though it is in its early stages of development. One way to think about this possibility is that the quantum field is constantly interacting with itself. This interaction can be thought of as a kind of feedback loop, where field is both observing itself and being observed by itself. When a measurement is made, this feedback loop can amplify the effect of measurement, leading to the collapse of the wave function. Another way to think about this possibility is that the quantum field is not simply a collection of particles, but a unified whole, when a measurement is somehow disrupted, leading to the collapse of the wave function. So, of course, there are still several models that have been proposed. One model is called decoherence program. It suggests that the collapse of the wave function is caused by the entanglement of the system being measured with the environment. Another model, called the many worlds interpretation, which also has been extended to multiverse interpretations, suggests that the wave function does not collapse, but rather splits into multiple branches, each of which corresponds to a different possible outcome of the measurement. This would imply that you and I exist in infinite domains. So here are some examples, maybe, how the quantum field curves through its own self-interaction. Measurements of the electromagnetic field. When we measure the electromagnetic field, we are essentially interacting with the quantum field. The interaction could cause the field to collapse its own wave function, leading to the measurement result. Measurement of the weak nuclear force. The weak nuclear force is responsible for radioactive decay. When a radioactive atom decays, it emits a particle that interacts with the weak nuclear force. This interaction could cause the weak nuclear field to collapse its own wave function, leading to the decay event. Is a theory that attempts to unify quantum mechanics and general relativity. If quantum gravity would be mediated by a quantum field. When we measured, this interaction could cause the field to collapse its own function, leading to the measurement result. So many ideas there, but basic idea. Measure implies kind of perceptual and cognitive activity. The activity could be sound, which means hearing. It could be seeing, it could be touching, it could be sensing, it could be smelling, it could be tasting. These are all modalities of experience. The act of seeing creates the seer and the scenery. The act of seeing. The act of hearing creates the one who hears and that which is heard. The act of sensation creates the experiencer of the sensation, and the experience of the sensation that occurs. So it is the act of seeing, act of touching, act of perceiving that creates the observer and the observed, the seer and the scenery, the knower and the known, the lover and the beloved, however you want to phrase it. So what is self-interacting as these activities? The quantum field is one way to say it, but because it leads to experience of seer and seeing, I think it's obvious that the quantum field is self-interacting to create experience. The quantum field is self-interacting to create experience. So it must be the source of experience. And the experience includes the seeing, the scenery, and the seer. But the seeing is what creates the scenery and the seer, the act. How is this important? Well, when you actually mindfully focus on a perceptual activity or an experience that we call seeing, hearing, touching, tasting, and smelling, then you create both the seer and the scenery. And the you that does this is not in space-time. Only the seer and the scenery are in space-time. The seeing is the act of an entity that is beyond space-time, and that's you. So let me know what you think.